Hey folks, welcome back to the workshop. I hope you are having a nice April. The weather is bipolar up here in Wisconsin. We are getting 70 degree days and then we get 11 inches of heavy wet snow. So what better time to still stay inside and keep building models? We're gonna do a new kits video and then I'm gonna dive into building some of those kits soon. I know it's been a little while since we've had a full build video and it's because I've been taking trips around too, been taking care of some stuff in the real world outside of models, and now we'll get back into kit builds, get ramped back up into two builds every single week, throw some other stuff in there. We're gonna start taking a look this video at ICM's latest releases. They've got some really awesome stuff coming. First, I wanna talk about their cool 2024 catalog. You can get this from them if you order direct or see if your hobby retailer can get you a copy. But I love printed catalogs instead of the digital ones. I just can't get into reading something like this on a computer, but they've got some excellent representations. Gorgeous box art done by their in-house artists, and then we will see what is coming down the line, and we should be getting a bunch of these on the show. Check that out. They've got some supersonic aircraft coming out. They're going to have, which I didn't find in this one, but it will be coming, is a really gorgeous 1/24th scale Model A. And I can't wait to get that on the show. I've actually asked them to send that over, two copies of it and two copies of the paint set. I'm going to be building it on the show using that kit and the paint set. And then I'm going to be giving one away to you folks out there. So when you see that video come up, make sure you watch it and enter in the way I say you can enter. Looking at kits that are available right now, they've got this really sweet looking 1/35th scale Servicemen of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, service women. And it's actually four female service people from their military. They, you know, they've got the women out there in combat roles. They've got a little drone here. They've got charging and pack equipment. They're even taking a selfie. It's like, you know, it's a digital world out there and they're using their cell phones and they're using drones. It's a very new type of war zone in Ukraine at this time. We wish them well. It is neat to see females in figure sets. We usually only see guys and stuff like that in roles, and it's nice to see something different. Also in 1/35th scale, this is their FWD Type B World War II U.S. ammunition truck. That is pretty awesome. All right, back in World War I, these things were kind of rudimentary. I love the solid rubber tires, the solid steel wheels, the excellent paint job on there. It's available now, kit number 35656 in 1/35th scale. Gives you three different options, covered and uncovered, on the kit there to build up as you choose. 1/35th scale is by far, the most popular scale for surface models of military. They've got their Studebaker US-6U3 U.S. military truck. It's kit number 35490. That is available now. You can build it up in one of four liveries. We've got all of our different emblems on here, numbers. We've got ones that were sold to the civilian market, which is nice to see. They've got some emblems on there. Fairbanks Freight, First Convoy, White Horse at Fairbanks, 1942. That's interesting that they put that stuff in there because these things were sold, of course, as surplus. Something that the diorama folks are going to like, and this is not just for the military folks. These landing mats can be used for any kind of vehicle display. They can be used for just about anything you can think of. Weather them up as you want. It's 1/35th scale. They would place this over soft areas, black earth, sand, mud, wetlands, so they could land helicopters, drive support vehicles to it. It actually is really detailed. You'll get a good look at it. It's kit number 53200, denoting that, yes, it's 1/35th scale, but it is a diorama piece. That's pretty interesting in this small thing. Now, where you can get more of that material is in this absolute unit of a model kit. This is a giant, again, 1/35th scale. It's pretty much a diorama in a box. It's got the gorgeous helicopter carrying a bomb. It's got eight figures for ground crew and pilot crew. It's got the ground mat that will fit this giant helicopter. We can see on the box, it is kit number 53056. It's going to be pretty awesome out there. What it all includes to make sure we get a description of the Fubai Air Base in 1968. It includes the CH-54A helicopter and the entire thing with the M8A1 airfield pavement slabs, the M121 bomb, the pilots, and the elements of equipment for pilots and technicians. In other words, right here on the side, we've got all this stuff that they need to work on it. Then we're also going to have 48 parts for assembling four figures of the helicopter pilots, 39 parts for assembling ground personnel, a total of, what does it say in here? A total of 604 parts just for the helicopter. That is insane. This kit is out right now. Again, 53056 from the folks at ICM in Ukraine. We'll set that big thing down. We got a couple more from them. We've got this really cool 1/72 scale submarine, the K-Verbande Midget Submarines. Got two submarines in the box. You can see how you can detail them up on the side. Always a nice paint guide. The box is very, very small. Kit number S.020 in 1/72 scale. So not going to be a very large kit. The submarines themselves were quite small. Back to 1/35 scale to round out the ICM offerings. We've got the big Kozak 001 Ukrainian National Guard armored vehicle, sort of their version of the Humvee that we use. 1/35 scale, 35015. I love the painting on this one. A lot of these are snowy, dusty, dirty, but Ukraine is a beautiful country, very, very similar to the upper Midwest where I live. That's why a lot of people from Eastern Europe moved here, Polish, German, Ukrainian, a lot of Russians, all that kind of stuff moved here. You get these beautiful white billowy clouds. You get the sunflowers, the green grass. I mean, the small trees. This is what I see in the summer all the time. So I think it's really cool to do a diorama as different than gloomy and dark with this awesome vehicle. And speaking of that, they did the same with the World War II British Army Mobile Chapel. Isn't that neat? So you can really enhance your dioramas of any series. And you could also use this as a civilian vehicle, traveling church in the South after World War II. They bought them surplus and all that stuff. They buy them, ship them back over from Britain, whatever they wanted to have. Really cool. It's got the piano, the pulpit, got some religious materials in there. 1/35 scale, kit 35586 available now. You can see how you can build it up with the white front so that they know it's not enemy, with the cross on it on there. A lot of cool stuff coming from Ukraine. So I will take all these kits. We're going to have some pictures of them after every demo so you can see the box art. You can get the model kit number if you missed it in the video and don't know how to use the pause button. We'll get those back on the screen. We'll put it up and then I will set up for the next vendor. Let's take it all the cool stuff that Atlantis Toy and Hobby has sent to the show. Now, one of these kits I've already built up, so you can go back and see that episode. They've got cool stuff coming out all the time. They do have some more car kits coming out, which is a lot of what I do on this channel. So we will be seeing those. They've got some Garlitz dragsters, all kinds of cool stuff, long nose dragsters, and funny cars coming out. We'll take a look at what's hitting the market right now. First up will be Ed Roth's Dragnut and Ed Roth's Rad Fink. Now, I did unboxings of these kits within another build of a kit that they released, which is the Mummy, the glow-in-the-dark Mummy. I love building figure kits. Don't get a chance to do as many of them. So I built up this beauty on the channel, and you can take a look at it. It's 8th scale. Nice large kit. Comes in at about 10 inches tall when you're all done with the base and everything. And you've got glow-in-the-dark options. You've got standard plastic options. You've got a lot of stuff going on in there. You can go to their website at Atlantis Toy and Hobby and pick those up. The Ed Roth Dragnut is a cool figure kit. These are all reissues of like old Monogram kits, Aurora kits, all that stuff. That's what Atlantis does. They purchase these kits, they add new decals, they clean up the molds, and they reissue them so we can live that nostalgia. They've got the cool built-up model on the back. You can see it's got a mini rat Fink in it. It's got the drag nut and his bucket hot rod. That's available right now. This thing is got 35 pieces in it, and assembly is quite easy. It's all pretty much in the hand painting. And even easier to assemble and build up is the Ed Roth Rat Fink, the iconic Rat Fink. We just saw it in the drag nut kit. People have t-shirts with this on from back in the day, the 60s, 70s, early 80s, when it was just the hugest thing. It's only got 8 parts in the box. You can build it up. You can paint it your way. This one's got a red outfit. A lot of times he's wearing green. Pretty much do the Rat Fink the way you want to see it and enjoy it your way. So you can snag that from Atlantis. Also just reissued for the airplane guys, the B-58 Hustler. It's got pilot and navigator and the radar man. So it's got 3 figures included. This is a sweet looking kit on the back. To give you an idea, it's an all metallic model. They've also got all kinds of other aircrafts. I love this Jenny biplane on there. I still have to build that on the show. One of these years, we'll get to it. But it's an easy to build kit, recent reissue. It's gonna be fun for you old model airplane guys. Yes, I know it's not as technically perfect as the new stuff, and that's not what Atlantis does. So all of you making those comments really missed the point of the entire mood at Atlantis here, building the old scale model kits we used to snag from Kmart back in the day and really enjoy. Coming up from Atlantis soon, they should be hitting stores right about now, are the old prehistoric scenes animals. So I've got to pick one of these to build. I did the mummy. I want to pick one of these to build. Probably going to be the bear, just because the saber-toothed tiger is cool. It's cool. But I see bears in real life, so I know what they look like. And saber-toothed tigers are awesome, but, you know, probably won't get the chance to build that one on the channel. It is a really cool kit. You can see build-ups on the back. Got the big teeth on there. He's swinging at you with his paw. You can set him, build him up. You can build him walking along the ground. It is an interesting kit. I've never actually seen it. So when I build the cave bear, we'll do an unboxing of that saber-toothed tiger, and we can see all the parts and everything. The cave bear is pretty cool. It's 1/13th scale, so is the saber-toothed tiger. And you can see this one, we build it. But this one's got like a cave. It's got skulls. We can do some groundwork, diorama work, paint the bear in different shades of brown. I really like that. So that's why I've decided that when I build it, that's the one I'm going to build. And then finally from Atlantis is a reissue of the 8th scale Wolfman, going with the Mummy, the classic monster series. They're reissuing these in the glow-in-the-dark, so you get the glow-in-the-dark option pieces. We're going to build it up. It's going to be a little bigger than the Mummy, I think, because it's on a base as well, and he's got his arms raised. So I think that's why it's going to be a little taller than there. But it's got skulls, it's got rats, it's got all the stuff to creep your mom out when you were a kid, built as the Wolfman from Lon Chaney's movies, same as the Mummy was. That's all that's been issued from Atlantis and sent to the show as of late. They've got some cool car kits coming up this summer. When they get those, we will build one of them, we'll unbox the other, we'll check them out on the show. I'm gonna set up the next set of kits. I'll be back in just a moment. Without a doubt. I mean, it's not even, the second place isn't even close enough. The company in the United States producing the most model kits right now is Round 2 Models. Every time you guys see one of their new kit videos and they're showing what their releases are coming up and you whine that nothing's coming out, you guys are full of it. They produce more kits, they push out more kits and more new kits than anyone else on the market, especially for automotive model builders. That it's hands down. You can't deny it. You can't whine about it. They produce so much stuff. Let's start taking a look at this massive pile of model kits that they have sent over to the show. For the sci-fi fans out there, and there are hundreds of thousands of you out there, We've got the beautiful USS Reliant, the NCC 1864. It's 1/537th scale. It's a very odd scale, but that's kind of how they did things back in the day. This is from Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan. It is a gorgeous model kit. It builds up quite nicely. You can make these look wonderfully. I've seen people work on these and light them up. We always talk about Jamie Hood over at Round 2 Models. He is a big sci-fi nut, and I completely get that. They are fun, they are exquisite, and they do a really good job of maintaining the molds on these and adding a lot of bonus features. On this one, we're going to get that really sweet polar light stand with the steel rod so that it holds it up. You get a nice decal sheet, and then the aftermarket and Round 2 themselves can supply you with a lot of cool Aztec-ing sheets and all that stuff for these models, lighting kits to get all the details even more well done. As always, you can build these on the back. This thing builds 18 inches long. It is a big model kit, and it is pretty awesome looking. Now, my personal favorite of the Star Trek model kits has been and always will be the Next Generation kits. All right, the Enterprise D. Now, they have sent this over. This is a recent reissue. This kit's been issued many times since the show came out, and the show came out back in the 80s. Can you believe that? Almost, we're getting on 40 years since the Next Generation's been released, and it doesn't seem like that, but it has been. In the more common 1/1400th scale is the NCC 1701D, and that describes Deanna Troi. It's a dirty joke for you guys. You'll get it. The USS Enterprise NCC 1701D in 1/1400th scale. Now, this comes with a massive decal sheet of its own to do all the windows and everything in the ship, or you can light it. This is cast in a translucent plastic. It's not crystal clear, it's translucent. What that allows you to do is paint the model kit and then scribe away the paint for the windows and stuff like that, and light it on the inside so that you can get the light shining through on the outside. And then, of course, the nacelles, the deflector array and stuff were already molded in that translucent. So when you paint them, the colors, the red and the blue, you will get the light to shine through them. Now, since I love this kit, and I haven't attempted to build this since I was a child when the show was out, they not only sent the kit to the show, knowing I want to build this one, they sent the available enormous decal sheet. This is full of all the Aztec and extra decals you need for the kit. Four huge sheets on here. We got some detail around the captain's ship and all that stuff. And this allows you to do all that Aztec paneling over the ship without having to mask or paint or anything. So we'll build the ship, we'll paint it, we'll get decals, and then we will go ahead and do all this work. And that will be definitely a video where you learn how to lay decals on a model ship. So we'll set that to the side. We'll be careful with that. We don't want to get those decals bent or folded. We will move on to the automotive kits, and they've got a bajillion of them. We've got the Ford Mustang II, the 1963 concept car. This is an interesting kit in 1/125th scale. It includes all kinds of parts to build the Mustang II concept car. It has a really nice decal sheet with striping options. I mean, this car was pretty much a one of one. What I noticed in the kit is that it's got opening doors even. And I didn't even know this kit existed, but yeah, it's pretty cool. It's got opening doors, you've got the custom steering wheel, we've got Goodyear tires, we got mag wheels, tri-carb system on this thing to replicate that concept car that they took around to auto shows back in the day to show them what they were going to be building. Now, you saw my video, my previous video before this one, was my trip to Round 2 Models in South Bend, Indiana, and they could not have been nicer. And when I left, of course, they couldn't let me leave without some model kits to show off. So, in addition to all the stuff on here, I came home with three model kits from that show. First up is the 1/125th scale Boss Nova, all right? So we got the Nova wagon with its mid-mounted engine, which is very, very interesting. We're going to get this one on the show. Chad actually kept talking about this and said he wanted to see my build of it. So, personal request like that from a cool guy like Chad, we're going to build it up. We've got engine options on here. We've got 8 carburetors with a supercharger. We've got fuel injection options. We've got all, I mean, look at these intakes on that thing. Really interesting. We got a helmet with a face mask. We've got a toolbox. We got those big honking slicks. Look at this thing. Because the engine's mounted in the center of the car, The actual air intake is up on the roof of the Nova. You can see all the parts in the back. Not a lot of parts in this kit. Excellent decal sheet to replicate the box art. Looks like a very simplified chassis. So this one should be a fun build that doesn't stress a person out too much. Also, snagged, direct, being handed models by people at Round 2 is even cooler than getting them in the mail. They've got the beautiful 62 Pontiac Catalina. 3-in-1. The box is very heavy, full of lots of parts. We got pad printed tires, drag slicks and white walls. We've got a nice decal sheet on there. We can build a stock version. We can build a race version or the full custom. You look at the back, look at all the parts trees in that kit. All right, two sets of tires on there. And we got the awesome 421 engine. I have built a version of this Catalina before. We're gonna build it up again on the show. Just because all those parts in the kits, I know you guys want to see it. Now, there are a bunch of kits on this table that I've built that have come in since we did our last new kits review. So those I'll go through a little quicker because when I show them on here, you can then go see the video on my channel just by searching 1960 Ford F100 pickup truck. This one's got the trailer in it. It's 1/25th scale. It's new tooling. They tooled it up for you folks. It's not brand new. It's a retooling of an old kit, but it's the tooling is all new. It's modernized. So when I say new tooling, I mean it goes together like a modern kit. It fits perfectly and it's got extra details and fun stuff going on there. So I want you to check out my build of this 3-in-1. We've got lots of options and decals on the box. We built up that awesome tri-power Ford engine on this one. Look at all the parts trees that are in that box and that decal sheet with Gulf livery on it and stock and custom decals on there. Go check out my build video of that. As you can see, I'll throw the empty boxes because those don't matter to me anymore. I get those recycled. Another in the build stage was the Cat. This was the last build I did before I left to see Round 2, before some other stuff went on, and we got all that in there. 1/25th scale, you can build it stock or full custom street machine. All kinds of extra parts in there. This one was built up on the channel. Take a look at the artwork on the back there. So much cool stuff. Very, very simple build. Very simplified build. 8 tires in there. 2 complete sets. That is on the channel. That's coming out soon. I don't know if that's available yet. Another one that we've built up on the channel is the 79 Chevy Nova. I built mine as a work in progress street machine. You can build it as a nice stock Nova. It is a 2-in-1 kit. We've got optional hood scoops. We've got optional dual quads. We've got side pipes, a gorgeous striping package. The kit goes together super easy. It is a very simplified kit with a total of 6 tires in the box. Built that one up on the channel. So go and check out that 79 Nova. We'll see a buildup of that. I'm just having fun throwing those, so calm down out there. One of my favorite kits of the new year here, 2024, has been the Touch Tone Terror. All right, I did not know this, and a lot of people didn't know this because they told me so in the video, that when you get this kit, of course, we also know it as the Little Red Wagon, but when you get this kit, it's Touch Tone Terror issue. There is cardboard dioramas inside the box to build up the phone booth and a bunch of other neat stuff. You can also build a completely stock Dodge work truck for the telephone company, and that's what I did. I built this rig right here. The doors open. It's got the roof rack, the ladder, the phone booth, the steelies. This was a lot of fun, and it's got the stock engine, so you get 2 complete engines in this kit. Check out the video on that. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and when that comes out as the Little Red Wagon again someday, hopefully, I will build that as well. So some kits I haven't built on the channel yet, sitting up here in front, is the 57 Chrysler 300. This is a full custom car. I'm not sure that you can build a stock vehicle. I don't think you can. You will let me know in the comments. The kit historians and the geniuses, I always appreciate their comments about no, you can, yes, you can, all that stuff. We're going to be building it up because I really haven't done any 300s on the channel. Very, very few of them. Does not look like a super complicated build at all. Awesome custom decal sheet. 1 set of tires in there, which makes me believe it's a custom only. Got the full frame on there. Awesome stuff. I actually have a personal family friend that owns a Chrysler 300 concept car. And if you know who, I've talked about him on other shows. I don't like to name drop a lot because sometimes they get bugged. He owns a giant business in Wisconsin and can afford cars like this. But one of his has the I think it's a French 4-speed in it. Whatever they did, they only made like 9 of them. He's got one. It wins a bunch of shows. So I'll build it up kind of in honor to my buddy there that has that car. Something I would never get to drive, even though it's his, because it's just worth too much money. And I would wet my pants in the driver's seat, worrying about crashing a car that could sell for $750,000. One of these ones that I love building all the time are the old school cars, the streamline, the aero era, the 1939 Ford two-door sedan. It's Tudor, as in like a teaching tutor, not two-door. So even though it has two doors, the T-U-D-O-R, sometimes my pronunciations up here in the upper Midwest confuse people a little bit. Beautiful car. We've got options to make it a 39 or a 40. We've got custom parts in here. It is a two-in-one kit. We've got the custom fuel injection engine on there. You can build it stock or custom. It's all, it says it's a four-way sedan. Build as a stock 39, a 39 street rod, a stock 40, or a 40 street rod. So see, we learn so much stuff. We tear open the box, we learn even more. Got all kinds of parts on there. Got the 39 and 40 hood. Looks like we can do the fenders a separate color if we want to do a custom job on there. Really, these kits go fun. We've got a set of 8 tires again. AMT throws a lot of stuff in their boxes. They love giving you guys all those little bonuses on the side. Next up, we built a lot of Stingrays on the channel. This is the 1972 Corvette Stingray convertible. My mom loves Stingrays. That's one of the only older cars she can ever identify. Every time we go somewhere, she's like, ooh, that's a Stingray. And then I'm like, yeah, I know. It's the only car you actually like from the old days. So, but it's funny, and it's a funny story, so maybe we'll build this one up, give it to her. It's got the luggage rack, which I always thought was interesting. The same guy that owns that Chrysler 300 Custom restored a 70 Challenger convertible, and it had a luggage rack on the back. The way they were using those cars back then is pretty funny. We've got Goodyear pad-printed tires. We've got red lines in the box. We've got the LT1 V8 under the hood. We can build it stock up, make it look really sweet. And we've got our parts diagram in the back. Full exhaust, one set of tires, pretty much just builds a really nice Stingray convertible without much muss or fuss. We've got some more kits. In fact, let's get them all down here. All these have been built on the show. Yes, I build a lot of kits. So when some of you are saying, how come you haven't built much end of March, beginning of April? Well, I was taking a little break, a little personal mind space, traveling to round 2. That is an interesting drive through Chicago. Gary, Indiana, getting to South Bend, exploring all of South Bend, the University of Notre Dame, and I knew there was a ton of kits I had built already this year so we could take a little bit of a break. Well, we'll get back to it soon. One of my favorite ones from the New Year's, along with that Touchtone Terror, is the Warlock. Gorgeous pickup truck. I keep bugging them, and you should keep bugging them in the comment section that now you want to see the Little Red Express since you've seen me build up the Warlock. This kit's doing really well on the market. Grab it. We know if it's been issued, we won't see it for quite a while. So if you want it, grab it. They are selling out quite quick. Built this up on the channel in the box art, minus the hood graphic, and I really, really enjoyed it. You also get to see in that video how to paint wood grain on a deck. Moving along, we got the 21 Dodge Charger Pursuit. I loved this kit. There are so much interior details that Steve over at Round 2 put into this car when he designed it, designed all the extra parts, threw some Easter eggs in there. We're going to see further renditions of this kit. I do know one of them. I'm not allowed to tell you what it is, but you will all be very happy to see that as well. So this is just hitting the stores right now. When this video is out, these have just come out within the last few days. So you should be able to snag it from Auto World Store, ModelRoundup.com, or your favorite retailer. So check out my full build of that 21 Charger. And we throw it to the side to be recycled. We've also got the 1960 Corvette. I did mine as a beautiful teal turquoise blue stock model. But this thing has a bazillion options. A 7-in-1 customizing kit. Watch this on the channel. I enjoyed that build doing it stock. But you've got options to build that engine one of 3 ways. We've got posable suspension. It's got all kinds of stuff. One of you has to do it as the box art because that thing is totally BA. We've got wheel options on there. One of 7 ways. It's got 10 tires in the box. If you like all those tires for options for your other kits, grab this because you will not be disappointed. Watch the build on the channel of the 1960 Corvette. Also, we've got the Ford F-100 camper pickup. I loved this one. I did it as a weathered build. It's even got an option for a supercharger. You can build it stock, custom, or work truck. They call it push truck. You can also work truck because it's got the push bumper. It's got the... Stuff on the bench right now is from three separate vendors. We've got Model Rectifier Corporation, we got the Agostini, and we've got Model Roundup / Salvinos JR Models. From Model Roundup, the latest kits I have in my shipments were the Junior Johnson Racing 1984 Chevy Monte Carlo. It's in 1/24th scale. You can build it as the number 11 or the number 12. So just know that in the box are the decals to replicate either car. Being 1/24th scale and being the older cars, we know that these are the reissued monogram kits, which go together beautifully, are highly detailed, and look awesome. And Salvinos always does a great job. They've retooled glass for a lot of these. They've retooled the tires. They've got that awesome chrome that they use. So you can snag that right now. It is on the market. And then the Chase Elliott 2024 Chevy Camaro ZL1. This is his Napa Auto Parts car for 2024. It's in 1/24th scale. It is the all-new Chevy Camaro ZL1 body on their beautifully newly tooled chassis with engine, wheels, tires, and a very, very extensive decal sheet to replicate everything you see on the box art. So head over to modelroundup.com and snag those latest Salvinos JR kits. Also at modelroundup.com is Model Cars Magazine. So if you're placing an order for some kits, pick up the latest issue. This is 223. They build up double deuces. They've got show coverage. It's got a lot of full color stuff in here. And it is the only magazine for model cars on the market in the United States. So snag that. Sent over by Model Rectifier Corporation, we've got Italeri's reissue of the Scania R143 M500 Streamline 4x2. Again, it needs a longer name when they start naming these vehicles. It's kit number 3950. This is a reissue. It is in 1/24th scale. My favorite part about this kit is the two Michelin men at the top of the visor on there. These are relatively easy builds. They go together without much fuss. So if you like the European trucks or if you just like the big trucks, go ahead, snatch these up. You can get them at modelrectifier.com or any hobby retailer. They're happy in the United States to get it to you. Just look up Italeri kit number 3950. And finally, from our folks at DeAgostini, they've got some more scale models coming out. Now, I'm not a huge diecast collector, but I told them I'd show you this on the show. They are coming out with a pre-built series of kits, or not kits, of models, with these 1/24th scale F1 racers. They're doing modern, they're doing older cars. This is from 2022. It's the F175 Charles Leclerc from 2022. So you can see all the detail in there. Now they're supposed to be sending more than one. It is a subscription base, like all of their stuff. That's how they make their money. It gives you a history book with each one of that car, of the driver, and lets you know about it, just like the build-up kits that we do on the show. And you can subscribe and get your first models on the way. So when they send me a couple more of these to make the video worthwhile on the show for you guys to watch, we'll take these out of their boxes, we'll unstrap them from their stands, we'll take a look at the whole kit and let you know if it is worth picking up. So that is our small scale vendors. I've got one more vendor on the list. I will stage for that and be back in a couple seconds. Thank you. wrapping up our new kits video, are the offerings from REVELL USA in the automotive line. I've got some other stuff coming from them for Star Wars and stuff, but it's not here yet. We'll look at the 1932 Ford Tudor sedan, 2-in-1, again, Tudor, 2-in-1 sedan. Allows you to build stockish and custom. It is a sweet hot rod on there. A total of 188 parts, 1/25th scale will be coming out. Look at the beautiful box art by Bob there. We've got that nice orange red. We've got the blue. Haven't decided which version I'm going to build up, but it is a sweet kit. Should build up relatively easy and we'll have a good time with it. A lot of these REVELL kits are not due till later in the year. So if you're wondering where they are right now, these will be the production versions, because I only request production versions, sealed in plastic, nothing that's been looked at by them or prepped or anything. So I always want what's going to be released. So we can tell that the test shots have been boxed and they're set to go. They've got their test samples. They receive usually a case or two of the model kits to send to the magazines, people like me. So that means should be expecting it towards the end of the year, as long as production levels stay and shipping stays. Maybe we'll see it in a month. Maybe we'll see it in 6 months. You never really know when these kits are going to come in, because it's kind of all depending on what the factory can get done and what else they're working on. So when you see these on the show and any other pre-production stuff, don't assume it's available in the store right now, because a lot of it will have to be pre-ordered. And you can always check with your retailers like modelroundup.com, who carries the entire REVELL line, REVELL Germany, REVELL USA automotive line, and they will get you set up as soon as pre-orders are available on those kits. Also coming out will be the 57 Ford Del Rio Ranch wagon. This is a must build. I love wagons. Wagons are pretty rare in the model kit world. It's 1/25th scale. Total of 197 parts. That's a lot of stuff in that box. Love the custom grill on this thing. It says newly tooled customized parts. Check out that nice buildup on the side. I mean, I like that box art. I might just do it just as it is on the box art, because that is really, really sharp. Even under the hood with the gold accents for the radiator and the oil pan. That's a great job. Bob does a great job when he builds those up for them. And something that we know is getting a buildup, because it's a square body and it's a 77, which is vintage me, is the 1977 Chevy street pickup with new wheels on this thing. I don't think there's any way to build this as a stock Chevy step side. I think we can only build this as a dropped customized truck, but we'll find out when we start building it. It's got 83 parts in the box, 1/25th scale, so it's not going to be a huge parts box buster. Like that purple paint job on there with the purple stained wood in the bed. Never really thought about doing it in a different color than wood grain. Got our customized small block under there. Check out those leg pipes out of the side. The side exhausts are not really leg pipes. They don't follow the bottom of the door or anything like that. That's a sweet ride, so we could do whatever we want with that stuff. These are the three offerings, the latest things I've gotten from REVELL. Haven't gotten a ton of stuff from them, but we do have some other stuff we need to work on, like that Bronco half cab and that Mustang Mach 1. So stay tuned. We're going to be building up REVELL stuff on the channel. I want to thank you all for taking time on Saturday to watch this video. I'm not going to have a personal stash on this one. This video's been long enough. We had a ton of kits to look at since we haven't done a video since like the end of 2023 for new kits. I've been building and traveling and dealing with personal life and real issues. So we will get stuff back on the channel. The next video we will see, we'll have a full model kit built up, and I will see all of you then.